Good day, dear students. Welcome to lecture 12 of Computer Programming in C. And in this particular lecture, we will discuss about the input functions, the functions that are used to take input from the users. Okay, or we can say the functions that our computer programs use to take input from the users. In our previous lecture, in lecture 11, we completed the discussion about the output functions, or we can say the functions that are used to print output on the screen. Okay, and in today's lecture, we will discuss about the input functions. So let me list some of the input functions here that we are going to discuss in this particular lecture. We will discuss about function scanf, getch, third getchar, and gets. So these are the four input functions that we are going to discuss in this particular lecture. So this particular function, this input function, it is declared and described, and its functionality is described in this library, stdio.h. So that means if you have to use this function, you have to include this library in your program. Getch, getchar, and gets. These three functions are described in conio.h. And remember that we are discussing about the console input function. So that means these functions will take input that is given to a program through the keyboard. Okay, they will take input from the keyboard. Let's discuss the first function, that is scanf. The scanf function, it allows us to enter data from the keyboard. So it allows to enter data from keyboard. And using scanf, we can take data in some standard format, or we can say that is formatted in a certain way. What I mean to say, I will make you understand. Let's first see the general structure of scanf. So the general structure of scanf is scanf. Whenever we have scanf function, it means my program will stop. Okay. So whenever it encounters scanf function, it will stop and it will wait for the inputs from the user. Okay. When it gets the input from the user, then only it will move to the next instruction. Okay. So in scanf, we have to determine what kind of inputs we want from the user. Do we want an integer input, character input, whatever we want. For example, if I want that user should type 5 integers. So first he will type integer 1, then integer 2nd, then integer 3rd, then integer 4th, then integer 5. So in that case, using scanf, I have to provide, or I have to determine what type of input I want. So that is determined, that is written inside this particular string. Okay. So whatever we want, let's say I want 3 integers. Let's say I want 3 integers from the user. 3 integers from user. So that means three integers, for example, user will print on the using the keyboard. Let's say 3 integers, 12. Okay, then he will press enter or space, whatever he want, enter or space. Let's say he presses space, then second integer, 3, 2, 5, then space, third integer, 4, 6. Okay, so after having 3 integers, this scanf function will complete. So user has entered how many integers? 3 integers. Because my scanf will say in this string how many integers I need from the user. Now user has entered 3 integers. Then after this, we have to give the variables in which we want to store this input. So these three inputs. So how many inputs we need? 1, 2, 3. Three inputs. So we have to give three variables here. And how will we determine that we will require three inputs? That is determined using this string. So how many variables we need, or we can say how many inputs we need from the user, that is provided here. And the variables in which we want to store the input, those variables are provided here. Then we have a closing break, semicolon. So here we are not giving the actual variables, we will give the address of variables. Address of variables. I will make you understand. Before understanding this, let's understand this. How will we determine, or how will we give here what are the inputs that we want? For example, if I want three integers from the user. How many integers? Three. Then I will write in this string, I will require %d %d %d. So if I have written %d %d %d, my scanf, it is going to find that I will require 1, 2, and 3. And %d is for which data variable? It is for integer. So scanf will understand that I have to take input how many integers? 3 integers. So that means user should enter how many integers? 3 integers. And those integers, or those inputs, should be separated by spaces. So %d %d %d. Now for example, I have to store these inputs in three variables. So what kind of variables I will use? I will use three integer variables. Let's say I have three integer variables a, b, and c. So this is declaring three integer variables. So when we are declaring three integer variables, that means we have a memory, and in this memory we have reserved how many spaces? Three spaces, three integer spaces. This is a, let's suppose this is b, and this is c. Okay. Now I am saying that my scanf function, it says to the user that you have to enter three integers. So user will enter 12, first 12. So this 12 should be stored at a. A means this memory location. So here we have to give the address of memory where we want to store it. So where we want to store it? Here, at location A. Location that is determined by A. To find the address of a location that is pointed by a variable A, that address is found out by AND A. So this AND. AND is used to find the address of variable. So AND A here means, so if for example address is 2000 is address. So AND A means address of A. Address of A. So AND A means 2000. So that means here I have to give address of A, and address of A will be AND of A. So this first one will be stored here. Then second one we want to store at B. So we have to give address of B, that will be AND of B. And third one will be address of C, that is C. So what will be the scanf function? Scanf will be %d %d %d. Then, so this is string, format string, AND A, AND B, AND C. Okay. And this scanf function, it is saying that user has to enter how many integers? 1, 2, and 3. And these integers should be separated by spaces. Now, if I want that user should enter 3 integers, but one integer on one line, then he should go to next line, then next line. For that I will do scanf %d backslash n percent d backslash n percent d, then and a and b and c. If we do like this, so user will print, for example, 12, then he will print 12 will go here percent d, so it will be stored in the first one a. Then backslash n means that user will print and user will press enter. Here backslash n means that he has to go to next line. Then he will print, he will enter 325. This 325 will be stored in B. Then again enter, then 46. This 46 will be stored in C. Now if you want that after entering the first one, user should press tab. Okay, and then another integer, then tab. Then instead of backslash n, you have to write backslash t. Let me give an example to understand scanf function. So for example, hash include studio dot h. Int main, int a, let's say I am writing printf, enter a, okay. So printf, it will say, it will just print this on the screen, nothing else. So it will print enter. This is the functionality of printf. It will print enter a. Then scanf. Using scanf, we can say that, let's say we want that user should enter some integer value. And we want that integer should be stored in a. Okay. So we want that user should enter integer. So that means we have to give percent d. And this integer should be stored in a. So and a. Then let's say I am doing return 0. So let's see what our program does. It will come here. Okay. It will print enter a on the screen. Then scanf. So that means if you see the screen that appears on your Windows system or on your Ubuntu system, the screen will show enter A. Then it will remain there. Why it will remain there? Because now scan function is running. This scan function will wait for the user. So it will wait for the user. It wants that user should print integer on the screen. He should write integer on the screen. So it will wait till our user enters something on the screen. Something means some integer, and that integer will be stored in A. So user will enter, for example, 12 and then press enter. So that 12. So for example, user has pressed 12 on the keyboard. So whatever he is pressing, that will be appeared, that will get appeared on the screen as well. So if he pressed 12, that will appear on the screen, and this value will be stored in A. So in A, we have stored 12. And what will be on the screen? Enter A and this 12. This enter A, this portion, this was printed because of printf function. And this 12 was printed because user entered 12. And scanf is then storing that value in this variable. Now, if we don't have this function, this particular function, printf. Now, let's see what how will program run. So int a, we are declaring a variable a. So there is nothing in this a. There is a garbage value. Then scanf. Scanf means our pop-up block will start. Pop-up block means that screen will start. That screen will wait. Why it is waiting? It is waiting because we have a scanf function. Scanf is saying that user has to enter something. What user has to enter? An integer. Okay, so this integer user will enter, for example, 56 on that screen. Okay, and then press enter. So 56 will get printed on the screen. 56. And also this 56 will get stored in A. So in A we get 56. Now after entering 56, for example, user pressed enter. So enter means it will go to this particular instruction. It will complete this instruction and this it ends the program. Ends the program means the screen will disappear. It won't be there. It won't remain there. So this is how scanf function is getting used. So why we are using this printf here in the initial case? We were using printf here because sometimes we want to inform the user what you have to print, what you have to give an input. So here in the second case, screen will appear, but user should know what I have to print here, what I have to give the input. Okay, if we are not using a printf function, it will work. Okay, but to inform the user what you have to enter, we can inform the user using printf function. Using printf function, for example, it will inform the user that you have to enter a value of a, then he can enter, for example, 56. This 56 will be then stored in a. Okay, so that means scanf function, it takes input from user, stores input in a variable. Also, whatever user enters, that appears on the screen. On the screen. So for example, here I am entering 56, so this 56 will appear on the screen. So what is the general structure of scanf? The general structure of scanf is scanf, then we have double quotes, then format, convergence specifiers, whatever we want input from the user, and then address of variables in which we want to store that variables. In which we want to store. Okay. Now let's take another example here to make you understand one disadvantage of scanf. Okay. So let me give an example here. For example, if I want that I need an input from the user, the input should be string. Okay, and string should be name of some person. So that means I need a array variable, character array variable to store the input from the user. So I will do hash include studio.h int main. Then let's declare a character array name. For example, name, and size is 40. Now I want that I have to inform user enter your name. Okay, then he will enter his name. That name, his name, that should be stored in this particular variable. For receiving input from the user, what function I have to use? Scanf. And what type of input here I want? I want a string input. Okay, and that string should be stored in this character name. So what we are doing, so let's first inform the user what you have to enter. Printf, enter your name. Okay, scanf, we want that user should enter string. So for informing that user should enter string, it is %s. And we have to store this string in which variable? In name variable. And here we are giving the address of variable. Because in scan function, we have to give the address of variable. And address of variable is written like this, %. But whenever you have an array, the name of array is the address itself. So you have to remember it. So this name here, name, it is the address ऑफ कैरेक्टर एरे नेम. ओके, सो इन स्टेड ऑफ यूजिंग एंड वी वोंट यूज एंड विद एन एरे. विद एन एरे वी डोंट यूज एंड. व्हाई? Because and is used to determine the address and the name of an array is itself an address. So here we will directly write name. So that means user will enter the name. That name will get stored in this particular array, in this character array. Now if I have to print the name, I will do printf your name. So let me rewrite it. Printf. So let's first go to a new line. So that means I want to print this on a new line. So I will do backslash n. Your name is percent s and name. Then return 0. Now let's see what this function does. It will first go here. It will make a variable name. That is an array. Okay. That is an array. So now on the screen. So let's say this is our screen. So screen will appear. That black screen. It will appear. It will say enter your name. Okay. So this is printf. It is saying enter your name. Now this will wait. Now we have scanf. Scanf means wait for the user to enter. Enter what he has to enter? A string. That string will be stored in this variable, name variable. So he will write his name. For example, I will write my own name, Janib, then space Bashir. Janib space Bashir. So this string, this should be stored in this name, in this name variable. Okay, fine. Now this is completed. Now printf. Printf means backslash n. So it will go to a new line. Your name is, it will print. Your name is percent s. Percent s means it has to print a string. So which string? This string, name string. So what was stored in name? In name we have Janib and Bashir. So it will print your name is Janib. It won't print Bashir. Why? Why it won't print Bashir? So basically whenever you are taking input using a scanf, it will only take input up to this space. Whenever you enter a space, okay, it will not take the next input. It will consider this is a different input. So this particular input will be stored in this variable name, and everything after that will be, this will be ignored. If you want to take this also as input, then you have to write another percent s and store that input in some other variable. So this is the disadvantage of scanf. So in name, we will be having only Janib. So that is why it is only printing Janib. Okay. So what is the disadvantage of scanf? The disadvantage is that whenever you have a space in between a string, whenever you have a space in between a string, it will only take the first part. It will not take the space part. Now let's say you want to use scanf to take this also and this also. Then you have to use another, for example, last name, another array. Okay. And here you have to do percent s, percent s. So two inputs. First input should be stored in name and second input should be stored in this one, last. So when I write Janib Bashir, in name, we will be having Janib, and in last we will be having Bashir. Okay. So that is the disadvantage of scanf function. Okay. So scanf function is used to take input from the users, and that input, when we take that input is printed on the screen as well, and this input will be stored in the variable. And as I said, the disadvantage is that it will not take an entire string if there is a space in between. Now, if we want to take the entire string, or for example, I want to store this entire string in this variable, name only. How will I do that? I cannot do that with the help of scanf, directly with the help of scanf. So there is another function, input function, that is called gets. Okay. Gets the input from the user, and it will store the input in a variable. Okay, so gets takes only one argument, and that argument will be the address of a variable in which we want to store the input. So, for example, instead of scanf, if I use gets here, gets means get input from the user, okay? And that should be stored in this variable, name. So, name is the address variable here. So, now program will run, enter your name. I will write ent janib space Bashir. So, gets will take the entire string. It won't ignore the spaces. It will take the entire string and will store in this variable. Which variable it is? Name. So it will store Janib Bashir here. Then if I am doing printf backslash n, your name is percent s name. So what is stored in name? In name we have Janib Bashir. Or instead of using printf, you can directly use puts name. So puts is also doing the same function. It will take this string or this character array and it will print this. What is this character array? Janib Bashir. It will print Janib Bashir here. So this is how gets differs from scanf. Scanf takes input in a certain formatted manner, but gets directly takes the input and stores in this particular variable, whatever the variable is. Okay, but gets, you have to remember it, this particular input function, this is described in conio.h. So for using gets, you have to use conio.h. But gets is rarely used. Most commonly, we use scanf function to take input from the user. So this completes our discussion about scanf function and gets. So gets takes an entire input and stores in a variable. So it has only one argument, but scanf has different arguments like printf. Okay. And both these functions, or we can say all these functions, they wait for the user to enter something. Okay. All these functions, they wait for the user. So this is completed. Gets is completed. Now comes get ch and get car. Get ch and get care. Get ch and get care. Ch here means character. Both these functions are used to take character input from user. So that means if you have to take only one character as input from the user, then you can use getch and getchar functions. However, if you have to take integer, if you have to take a string, then you cannot use these functions. They are the opposite of putch and putchar. So putch and putchar, they were printing one character, but these two are taking one character as input from the user. So they will wait for the user for one character. They cannot take more than one character as input. Get ch and get char. Okay. Basically, whenever get ch and get char are used and user presses some character, they will return that character and that character will be stored in a variable. For example, So let's say I am doing character A. Now if I use A is equal to get CH. So get CH has no here, has no argument here. Okay. And if I do put char, put CH A, now again I am doing A is equal to get char, then put CH A. Let's see what will be the output. Let's say it is all in the main. So here we are making a character. Okay, so it is a variable. Variable, there is nothing stored in A yet. Now, A is equal to get CH. So get CH function is called whenever a function is called, whenever printf or get CH or scanf is called, screen will appear. This screen. Okay, and this screen will remain here till our program ends. Okay, so screen has appeared. Now it is waiting for the user. Waiting for user a single character, input as a single character. So this screen will be here. So user will enter some character. For example, he has entered x, small x. Okay. So get CH will take this x and it will return x. Return value will be stored in this variable. So we know return is always stored. Whatever a function returns, that return value is stored here. Okay, so in A we have character x. Now we are doing put CH A. Put CH A. So we are outputting A. A is a character variable. So what is stored in A? X. So it will print X. Now we have again A is equal to, so screen will remain here. It won't go anywhere. A is equal to get scare. Now again, we are telling to the user that you have to enter a character. Let's say now I am entering A. So when we have get scare, when we were having first get CH, we inputted X. So up to this, was there anything on the screen? There was nothing on the screen. So that means get H, for example, for scanf. Scanf, whenever user was giving some input, that input was appearing on the screen. For example, 12, it was getting written on the screen. But when we have get CH and user enters a character, that character won't appear on the screen. It will directly get stored in this variable. After this, we are doing put A. Put A, that means it will print X. And now we have get char. The difference between get char and get CH is that in get char, when a user presses some character, that character will appear on the screen. For example, user is pressing A, capital A. This A will appear on the screen. Also, this get CH returns this value into this variable. So this variable was storing A. Now it will store. This was storing X. Now it will store A. After that, we are doing put CHA. So we are outputting A. What is stored in A? So this will be the output. And after this, our program ends. So this screen will disappear. So screen comes at the start of the program and it disappears when the program ends. Fine? Okay? So you got the difference between get CH and get char. Both are taking one character as input and returning that character. But get CH does not echo the character on the screen, but get char echoes the character on the screen. That is the difference between get CH and get char. Okay? So before concluding this particular lecture, let me write one program here. For example, hash include studio dot h int main int a is equal to 5, printf a is equal to percent d and a, okay, return 0. Now let's see what this function, what this particular program does. I have to make you understand one simple program here. So int a means we have variable a. So as I said, whenever program starts, a screen appears, that black screen. Okay, and everything will be printed on this screen. So int a will be declared, so nothing will be there on the screen. A is equal to 5, so it is doing internally, nothing on the screen. Print f, so it will print a is equal to %d, 5. %d is a, 5. And then return 0, so program ended, this will disappear. Now program executes so fast that you won't be able to see this screen. In most of the cases, you won't be able to see this screen. So it will pop up and it will disappear within microseconds. So this will get printed, but you won't be able to see the screen. But because it will be so fast that you won't be able to perceive it. So, but I want that screen should remain there. I should be able to see this. A is equal to 5. So I have to make my screen wait here. So how will I make my screen wait here? So that I can see the output on the screen. So for that particular case, in most of the programs we use, it is not a standard method, but in our lab works or in our lab programs, we use an input function. Because what an input function does, it makes the program to wait till the user enters some input. Okay, so that is why most of the programs you will see get ch function at the end. So let's see what will happen because of this function, getCH. What is the functionality of getCH? GetCH is an input function that waits for the user to press some key, press some character. Okay. So what now using getCH, what will happen there? So like this, so screen will appear, A will be equal to 5. In previous case, it was printing A equal to 5 and screen was disappearing. Now in this case, it will print A is equal to 5. Now we have function getCH. GetCH means this screen will remain here. It will wait for the user to press some character. So screen will remain till to the point, up to that point when the user presses a character. When the user presses some character means this function will get executed. So he presses the character, this will get executed, program will end and screen will disappear. So that is why in most of the programs you will see getCH function at the end. This is just used to make the screen remain here for some time to wait for the user to enter the character so that we can see the output on the screen. Otherwise, screen will disappear within a moment, in fraction of a second, and you won't be able to see the output on the screen. Now, that is why in most of the programs, getCH, or you can use getCHAR also. It is your wish, whatever function you want to use. So, but getCH is most commonly used because whatever user enters, that won't appear on the screen. Because getCH does not echo its input on the screen. Okay, that is why getCH function is used. Basically, what is the use of getCH function? It is an input function that takes input from the user. Okay, so only one thing that remains here, the return value of getCH and getCHAR. What is their return value? Their return value is the character that the user enters. But what is the return value of scanf? Like printf. So we were having printf. So what was the return value of printf? The return value of printf was, its return value was the return value was length of string it prints, and that return value can be stored in an integer variable. Okay, likewise scanf also has a return value. The return value of scanf is the number of inputs entered by user. For example, if I am doing scanf, %d, 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 and a and b and c. A, b and c are three integer variables. So because of the scanf function, how many inputs will be entered? 1, 2, 3. So what will be the return value of scanf? It will be 3. So you can store that in some other variable. For example, in variable d, you can store this value 3. So with this, we completed the discussion about the input functions. Okay. So up to this point, after lecture number 12, we completed the discussion about almost most frequently used input and output functions. And now you can use these input and output functions to make your programs, any kind of program, and you can print the text on the screen, or you can take input from the users. And these two functions, printf and scanf, these are the most commonly used functions. This will print string on a monitor, on a screen, and this will take input through keyboard. So these are most commonly used input and output functions. So this completes our discussion about console input output functions. Okay, so let's meet in the next lecture. Till then, goodbye.